Welcome to Architecture Minute. Let's talk about style, which is pretty much a meaningless term. Style is somewhat of a myth, as we shall see.
First of all, stylish, in the sense of fashionable, is a term that doesn't belong in architecture. Stylish may apply to the fashion industry, automobiles, perfume ads, and the latest popular color, but those things are too ephemeral to be useful in architecture. The fashion industry needs to come up with something new every season to engage people's interest. Architecture aims for timeless values appropriate for buildings that may last for centuries. In architecture, fashion is often conflated with the style of a building, classic, Victorian, Art Deco, but style is a slushy concept, more mythical than real. An architectural history class will typically introduce classical architecture with the five types of classical styling, easily identified by the types of columns used: Tuscan, Doric, Ionian, Corinthian, and composite. These were iconic elements in classic Greek and Roman architecture. In a sense, these classical styles remained in style over the centuries, through Romanesque architecture and the Renaissance and on. In more recent times, the same elements were recombined in neoclassical architecture, such as the U.S. Supreme Court, constructed in 1935. It's hard to identify different styles if they're all using the same hard elements. Which is classical? Which is Roman? Which is neoclassical? And what do we make of a confection like this, a 20th century movie theater that piles on various classical elements in a mound of parody? Is it classical in style? Or what to make of this 1920s design for the Tribune Tower competition, a skyscraper in the shape of a Doric column? Does that classify it as Doric in style? Then we have Victorian, Art Deco, Modern, Expressionist. There are hundreds of architectural styles, and it is often impossible to distinguish modern from modern from modern from modern just by calling it this or that type of modern style.
Clients sometimes come to me and state that they would like a traditional house. Well, what does that mean? All of these images are traditional in style, but they're all very different from each other. They're different types of traditional architecture. Perhaps it would be more useful to talk less about style and more about the qualities that make good architecture. Qualities like balance and proportion, honest use of materials, interiors that are uplifting and useful, and buildings that reflect their purpose. All of these things have more meaning than naming a style. That's Architecture Minute. Please join us again, and please subscribe to this YouTube channel, and please like this video. Thanks.